In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can go ahead and make a Twitch banner utilizing a free tool called Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right into it. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go to the description of the video. The first link there is gonna give you access to Adobe Express for you to be able to make your free account to be able to go ahead and do this today. So once you have your account set up and you're logged in, you'll be brought to a dashboard just like this. And you're gonna see here just how easy it is to be able to go ahead and make a Twitch banner. So that way you're branded, you look professional, and viewers start taking you serious when they land on your Twitch profile. So the first thing you want to do is you want to come here to the left-hand side and select custom size. Very important. Here for the width, we're going to go ahead and put 1200. For the height, you're going to go ahead and put 480. And this is going to give us the perfect size for Twitch. So once you're here, you're going to see that you're going to have a clean canvas. It's going to give you options for templates. And the good thing about Adobe Express, they give you so much stuff that you can utilize: photos, shapes, backgrounds, everything that you're going to see. I'm going to show you here today just so you can see how you can use this for more than just your Twitch banner. So the first thing we want to do for our banner is we want to go ahead and create a background. Now, because of the fact on Twitch, you have a video in the middle of the screen, you don't want to put text and things of that sort on your banner. You want to keep it very simple. You want to do a nice background color, maybe add some shapes, some elements, and potentially put your logo in the center for the mobile version. And that's what we're going to do here today. So let's go ahead and begin with backgrounds. So on the left hand side, you're going to want to select backgrounds. And now you're going to come and scroll down. You can select any background that you like. Now, I personally like to go ahead and scroll down and look for chromatic, hit more, and then you can simply select any kind of color that you want here. I like to go for blurred colors, and I typically like to look for something that's going to stand out. Like, let's use this one. You simply just click on it, and that's going to go ahead and add the background directly here into your Adobe Express account. So now that we have our background, let's go ahead and add a few elements in there, right? So this is a great opportunity that if you have your own logo, you can go ahead and upload that now by coming here to where it says photos. Upload the photo, and then you'll be able to upload your logo. But if you don't have one, here's the beautiful thing: Adobe Express has some logos you can actually use. So we'll type in gaming logo and we'll simply hit enter, and you'll see here that we'll get a few options here out of the blue that you can go ahead and select if you like one. I really like this Eagles one. Now, one thing you got to keep in mind: if you see anything with a crown, that means it's not included in the free plan, it's only on the paid plan. So if you look at the Adobe pay plan, I mean, for $9 a month, it's amazing what you actually get, right? You get over 20,000 files and graphics and things that you can utilize. You can schedule your stuff to social media. So this is also a good tool to be able to post things to social media and things of that sort. So you get a lot of things for $9 a month. So if you do see something that has a crown, it does require a paid plan, and that is your choice to be able to utilize or not, but is available for $9 a month. And anything that doesn't have a crown, you're going to be able to go ahead and utilize. So again, I'm just going to go ahead and utilize the Eagle for the purposes of this example. That's going to go ahead and add it in there for me. Now, you're going to see here that it has a white background, right? And I don't want that. Well, the good thing about Adobe Express is that with a click of a button, you can actually remove the background of any picture. So we'll click that. We'll come here to where it says remove background. And then it's going to automatically remove that background for us to be able to utilize the logo a little bit better. So you'll see that it's removed. Hit auto. And then after you do that, go ahead and hit the little check mark. You're going to see here then now that's done. And what we simply want to do is just want to size it. Don't make it too big, because what it happens is you don't want it to showcase on the desktop version. You want it to be more for the mobile experience, right? So now that we have that there, what we want to do is we want to make this background look a little bit better, right? So this is a beautiful thing you can do here. So we'll go to shapes. We'll go ahead and use the square. Just find the square here. Let's take a look right here. And here you're going to be able to go ahead and just add some kind of elements. Now, again, you can follow along with what it is that I'm doing. So I'm just going to turn this a little bit slightly sideways. I'm going to go ahead and bring it in. And then I'm just going to size it just like this. And you're going to see what we're going to do here in just an actual moment. So here on the right hand side, this is where you're going to be able to edit the shape. So we're going to change this to fill in the inside to be black, because we want it to match kind of like our logo. Border, we're going to say yes, because we want a white border. Okay, and now here you're going to see here that you can make this smaller. And now you can bring this here. And what we want to do is make it a little bit bigger, turn it a little bit. And then what we want to do is we want to go ahead and size it up just so that it fits in this corner. So we'll set it just like this. I like to just match it up bring it a little bit wider. And now you're going to see here that now we have one side completed. Now, one of the things you can do is you can click this, and here is this little plus icon. You're going to be able to duplicate it, because what we simply want to do is we want to go ahead and just rotate it, change the angle of it, and make sure we do the same thing on the other side to be able to get it to look good as well. So we'll just come here, maybe have to turn it a little bit more. And then you're going to see here that we're going to be able to go ahead and add that in there. So once again, there we go. So now we have our banner. Okay, everything is looking good. Now, I kind of want to make this to be towards the bottom. But again, you can see here just utilizing the stuff inside of Adobe Express, how easy it is to be able to go ahead and start creating things, even if you don't have no kind of experience. So again, I'm going to add it just like that. And now here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and center the logo just a little bit better, right in the center. Okay, so now we have kind of like our banner created, right? But now we want to give it a little bit more color, make it pop a little bit. So what I want you to do is click on the background, and you're going to see here it's going to say edit background. That's how you know you've selected it. We're going to come to where it says enhancements, right? And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and increase the saturation to make that blue just pop a little bit more. We're going to go ahead and reduce the shadows, add a little bit of highlights. Now, this doesn't have to be perfect, but here are the figures you can do. And then we'll increase the contrast. And you see here that now it's nice and blue and it's actually popping. So what we want to do once you have that banner completed, you want to come to the top. You want to go ahead and hit download, and you want to make sure you select PNG start download. Right, so that's going to go ahead and download directly onto your computer. Most likely it's going to go to your downloads folder. And then what you want to do is you want to come back to Twitch. Right now, you don't want to keep this basic generic background, because it's not going to give you that professional look that you're looking for. And that's what we're doing this banner here today. So on your Twitch profile, once you're logged in, you're going to click on your profile icon. You're going to come to where it says channel, and that's going to bring you to this page here. Where it says customize your channel, you're going to select edit. Once you do that, that's going to bring you here into your creator dashboard, where you're going to be able to go ahead and edit what we see. So you're going to come to where it says brand. You're going to go ahead and select that there. Then here where it says profile banner, you're going to select custom image, but you're first going to select upload, and you're going to upload the image that we just went ahead and created. So we'll select that there. You'll see that it'll go ahead and upload. And then it says success. And now what you want to do is you want to select custom image. You want to select save. And now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and refresh your channel browser to be able to see the new banner appear on your profile. So you can see here that now the banner is there. Again, remember, the logo is going to be covered on the desktop version, but you still have the branded sides that you're able to do there. And then what you'll see here is that on the mobile version, which is typically where people watch Twitch either way, you're going to see that it's going to look very professional, just like I have it here on the screen where we've made the banner. You see the logo and you have that branding in there. Now, that is the beautiful thing about Adobe Express. You can see how we went ahead and set that up. Now, it's super important that, you know, you just made a professional banner. You don't want to just have a generic profile picture either. This also is super important for you to be able to go ahead and have branding, for people to recognize you, and for you to increase your subscribers, your followers, just because people can start to recognize you. So go ahead and click this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and make a profile picture for your Twitch utilizing the same tool we just used today for your banner. So go ahead and click that right there, so that way you can fully brand your Twitch profile and look professional all the way across the board. Click that video right there. I'll see you guys in the next video.